Pat Buchanan, of all people, went on Sean Hannity's show and was talking some sense about Iran to Mr. Blowhard himself.
Pat, shouldn't it be a prerequisite that Iran stops being the number one state sponsor of terror, that they stop saying that it's non-negotiable, Israel's destruction, and that they stop saying death to America before we even sit down at the table with them?
No, no, Sean. Look, in 1956, Khrushchev says, "We will bury you Americans," and 3 years later, he was in the White House with Dwight Eisenhower. You got to talk to your enemies. Ahmadinejad, the former president of Iran, came out and said, "We're going to wipe Israel off the map." It was beer talk.
They've said
it
doesn't. Pat, that's not beer talk.
He was in office 8 years, Sean, and he's back teaching in college.
You don't believe them? Wasn't that a mistake we made in World War II, that the only person that seemed to really understand the nature of Hitler's ambitions was a guy by the name of Winston Churchill? Wasn't he the one guy that understood that he really meant what he said?
Sean, Ahmadinejad was in power for 8 years. He did nothing. He was a blowhard. Are we going to be frightened by words from some character in Iran?
Hey, Pat, what do you mean blowhard? The blowhard that supplied Hezbollah rockets and other terror groups rockets to fight a proxy war against Israel. They're fighting a proxy war now against Saudi Arabia and Yemen. This is all Iran, Pat. What part of this are you missing?
I'll tell you what, Sean. In Iraq, Iran is fighting ISIS and Al-Qaeda. In Syria, they're fighting ISIS on behalf of Assad. In Yemen, they're not involved there.
You think that the Iranians are our friends?
Sean, they're not. They're fighting our enemies. I'd rather have Iranians up there fighting in Tikrit and dying than American kids there. And the reason Iraq is in the camp now, very much of
so you Iran, don't have any problem with the seal of Barack Hussein Obama ultimately being on an Iranian nuclear weapon with their history of being a state sponsor of terror, fighting proxy wars, threatening Israel to annihilate them and the United States. You have no problem with that.
Listen to the American head of intelligence. He says Iran does not have a bomb program as of 2013. Secondly, if they start building a bomb, we will know it. Third, Iran has made some concessions that are not enough that makes them less able to get to a bomb.
Go back to 2012, and we found out they were far more advanced in their nuclear production and program than we ever thought possible. That's what that's what Obama's own government said.
Your friend Bibi has been talking about Iran getting a bomb since 1992. In 2006, he said they'll be building 25 bombs by the end of the decade.
You don't have any concerns at all about sitting down. By the way, and there's a big difference between the Cold War and the Russians that had nuclear weapons and America paving the way for them to get nuclear weapons, considering I would argue that before any negotiations take place, Pat, I'm not against negotiations, but first you have to change your behavior. Stop being a state sponsor of terror. Stop fighting proxy wars. Stop funding groups like Hezbollah and other groups. How's that?
Sean,
Pat.
In Syria, in Iraq, okay, the Iranians and their allies, Hezbollah, the Shiite militia, who are a dreadful bunch, Assad, are fighting ISIS. They are fighting Al-Qaeda. The Houthi rebels in Yemen are fighting ISIS and Al-Qaeda.
And how ironic that we're serving as their air force in those instances, in large part.
Who are they killing, Sean? They are killing our enemies. They are killing our enemies.
Sean Hannity's like, "I can't believe we're acting as their air force in that respect." But you want to be the air force of ISIS! Because you want to attack the Shias! The Shias are fighting the fundamentalist Sunnis, aka ISIS! So, what a ridiculous argument. He said, we're paving the way for them to get a nuke. Did you read the deal at all? Did you even read any articles on the deal which sum up the different provisions of the deal? It's absolutely crystal clear. They are not getting a nuke. They're only allowed to enrich to 3.67%, and you have to enrich to 90% to get a nuclear weapon. You have the IAEA up their ass. They're under constant surveillance. They're shutting down one of their nuclear facilities. They're capping their number of centrifuges. This was a fantastic deal, and all we have to do is gradually release or lift the sanctions once they prove that they're complying. So the idea that, like, we're being soft here on Iran is absolute nonsense, and we're not paving the way to a nuke. We're cutting off any possible way they can get a nuke. So he's just simply misleading on it. And I also love when he says, Iran is the number one state sponsor of terror. And where did you pull that fact from? Your anus? The American Enterprise Institute? Some other neocon bullshit pseudo so-called think tank? That's where you pulled that from? You do know that our so-called ally, Saudi Arabia, people in the Saudi government, funded 9/11, fund Al-Qaeda, cheer on ISIS. But, oh, Iran, their number one state sponsor of terrorism. Oh, you mean the thing going on in Yemen right now? It's basically a civil war between Houthi rebels and Sunni fundamentalists. You know who was in control of Yemen, the failed state, before the Houthi rebels went in there? Al-Qaeda! Al-Qaeda! We put in a little puppet, so-called moderate Sunni, that we pretended was leading Yemen, but if you watch the Vice documentaries from a few years ago, they talk about how it's already a failed state, man. It's Al-Qaedaville, okay? That's what we're talking about with Yemen. So Houthi rebels go in there, and now all of a sudden I'm supposed to be angry and scared that the Houthi rebels took over? Like I said, I don't like either. I don't like the fundamentalist Sunnis or the fundamentalist Shias, but if I had to sit back and pick, which side would I rather win? ISIS and Al-Qaeda or Houthi rebels or Shia rebels? I'm gonna go with the Shias. Sorry. Nice to know that you're on the opposite side of that, though, Hannity. I really appreciate that. And to the idea of, like, oh, they said they don't think Israel should exist. Do you believe that? Yeah. But as Pat Buchanan said there, it's empty rhetoric. It doesn't mean anything. You don't even have the ability to do that. When you look at our rhetoric, Duncan Hunter talked about how we should nuke Iran. So by your own logic, they should never consent to sitting down with us. And also, the idea, oh, they're a state sponsor of terror. And what are we? We've never done state-sponsored terrorism. We didn't maraud our way through South America, overthrowing democracies and putting in fascist dictators. We never overthrew their fucking government in 1953? How ridiculous are you? We overthrew their government! We could have a conversation about the other areas where we did state-sponsored terrorism, but there, we overthrew their government. The CIA did. They admitted that. It's in declassified documents. So, you know, this kind of thinking that comes from people like Sean Hannity, it's dangerous. Because, like I said, if you have the Iranian government under Hassan Rouhani being more open-minded on this issue in foreign affairs with the U.S., and they sit down and they agree to a peace deal, and U.S. Democrats sitting down and they agree to a peace deal, but you have the Republican Party in America and the Likud Party in Israel saying, no, I don't even care what the terms of the deal are, no, no. Well, then who are the bad guys? If the Iranian government is saying, yes, peace deal, agreement, yes, and the Democrats are saying, yes, peace deal, yes, and the government of Israel and the Republicans here saying, no, no, we're opposed. Well then, how can you warmonger and fearmonger about them? They're not the problem anymore. They just agreed to peace. You're the people that are saying no peace under any circumstances. So that means you need to look in the mirror because you're the issue here.